Hello all Angry Birds and welcome to this tutorial on how to copy things in CMD. So first I will just show the current path I stand in, like what folders and files I have. So I have this file.txt, I have history of Sweden of course, .txt, and I have a folder with a file inside it, and I have an empty folder inside that, and also a folder with a file. So what we will learn is how to copy a text file, and then how to copy a folder and all files inside it, how to copy a folder with all files and subfolders inside it that also have files inside them, but not the empty folder. And then lastly, I will show how to copy this entire thing with empty folders and all subfolders. So first off, we can just use the command copy, which will let you copy only files actually. So you type the name of the file you want to copy, and then the new name of the file, and you hit enter, and you can see that one file was copied. But what if I try to do this with a file? So we can try with my folder, for instance, and then we copy it into my new folder, and we hit enter. You can see that one file was copied. So let's look at the file tree again. We can see that we now have this file underscore new, just as we expected. But then we have this my new folder, but actually this is not a folder, it's a file. So if I try to delete it with the delete command, which of course you only can use on files, you will actually see that it is deleted, which proves my point. So what you have to do if you want to copy a folder, you have to use the command XCOPY, which stands for extended copy. And then you can write the name of the folder you want to copy, and then we will place everything in my new folder once more and press enter. And then it asks you if this is a file or a directory, because you can both copy files and directory, but it has to know what kind of animal it is, sort of. So we press D for directory, and you can see that one file was copied. And so this is the default behavior, that it looks inside the folder you specify, and then it just takes all files it can find, which is only this file.txt. So if I once more type like out the tree structure, you can see that we only have the file.txt here. But what if we create a new folder 2, and now we specify that we also want all subfolders, which we can do with this command S for subfolders, and press enter. It asks if it's a directory or not, and now you can see that two files were actually copied, and you show the tree, and also you see in my new folder 2 that we have a text file and the folder with the file 2.txt. And now the final step is if we also want to copy empty folders. So what we then do is that we, instead of slash s, we write slash e, which stands for subfolders and empty folders. So you create this third folder now, and it's a directory, so we press D, and then you can see that everything was actually copied, let's see, in the tree here. So now my new folder 3 looks exactly like my folder, as we wanted. But maybe you don't want to get prompted all the time when you specify a new folder that you want to place things in. What you can do is use this slash I command, and we use the folder 4, press enter, and now you can see that it didn't prompt me and asked me if it was a file or a folder. So this is very useful if you know that it's a folder you want to create, sort of. But still, what happens if you try to override something and copy everything in my folder into this new folder 4 again? So we try to just hit enter here, and then it asks us, do we want to overwrite the things? So let's say we want to overwrite everything, so we press A. But maybe you think it's annoying to have to do this in two steps, especially if you write a bat script, then it would waste for the next command, sort of. So what you can do is that you could already, before the command is run, you could decide what you want to answer. So you write echo and then A for all. And then you say that this thing will get piped, like this will be redirected to the next command. So this command will have this in reserve as the answer for the question that it will prompt. So now if we press enter one more time, like that, yes. and now you can see that everything was copied just as before, and it didn't ask any question. And this will also work if we type, like, let's say folder 5. Yeah, so this is the most robust way to just copy everything. Don't have to deal with override issue. Thank you so much for watching. I hope you enjoyed it and learned something. Bye.